can't believe,
Pick
he's
Esper,
here.
he is.
What the fuck? Wait, did you see that snipe?
Good gotcha. Good gotcha. No, pick Esper, he is.
Scream.
No, I'm recording.
Alright, then I guess, you know what, maybe it was...
This is actually a Joe Sun post.
Oh, hello.
Okay. Well, here we go.
Get acquainted with your movement. You have step dash.
Step dashes.
Step dead.
Kind of like nanners.
You have step dash. You can't cancel your step dash into anything until it's over.
Oh,
okay. Got it.
What you're talking about.
I got that.
Okay.
That's very limiting, but also powerful.
Okay. There's only three buttons you need to know. Okay.
Right.
2A. Very fast, very strong. 5B. 5B, 5C, right?
Food.
Doesn't matter, these are all filler. 6C. This kick? Important. Okay?
Got it. Is this for neutral?
Nope. Crouch, 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 crouch.
Alright.
Press 2A after 6C.
What?
Press 2A after my 6C.
Oh. Bruh. I'm pressing fucking 3C like troglodyte.
One of my favorite words.
Okay, now stand block it.
But only if it's preceded by the word fucking.
Do you understand?
Oh, wait. That's very strange.
Do you understand?
I think
I
understand.
Okay.
Alright, I'll explain to the class. I'll tell it to the class.
Yeah.
Okay, do it again. When I'm crouch blocking and he's 6C, he's either plus or neutral.
Okay.
And when I stand block, well, that didn't work, but...
Don't EX guard it. EX guarding fucks it up a little bit.
Yeah, well, anyway, he's minus.
Okay.
For some reason.
Yeah, you get it now?
Why? I don't know.
This is just how the character works, okay?
That's just a very strange thing.
So you're the only combo you need to know is anything A, B, C, right?
Oh.
2-3-6-A. That's your entire combo. Don't do it crouching. Do it standing. That's your whole combo, okay? You don't need to know literally anything else. Okay? Your throw range is fucking massive. Alright? That's the other half of this. That's the other half of this equation, right? So you're plus all the time, and you can make yourself more plus and get back in with 6C.
Yeah, my thing with Reese is like always been that movement is unbearable.
Step dash is very good. Because it's hard to react to.
Okay, 5B is really high.
No, that's 2B. You're thinking of 2B. There's 2B is an anti-air, but stop worrying about that.
Why is that? Why
stop,
is like
stop,
that?
Stop. Don't ask the question. This is not why, right? We're not even going to jump with this character, okay?
No aerials, got it.
We're like not, like she has good air buttons, but we're not going to jump. This isn't the point of it, right? This 2A, it's a fucking low. Okay?
It doesn't look like one, but it is. I see 6C does a lot of shield damage.
So, do you understand now, right? This is a low, right?
Yep.
And this is essentially a high.
Basically a high.
Right? Yes. And you can't react to it. There's no way in hell you react to it.
I have to guess.
Yeah? 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 So now you understand, right? So, the part two of this, right? Is, how does this work? Like, okay, this is your mix-up, right? I'm going to corner myself, try and mix me up. Just using 2A, 6C, right? Try and get me to get hit by the 2A. Nope.
button.
Just do 2A, 6C. That's all the buttons you need. Stop pressing B buttons. There we go. You see?
Oh, I understand now.
You understand now? Okay, try and block me doing it.
No, it will not happen.
Maybe I'll watch this VOD later. Nah.
Nice, there we go. You stood block stance 60. Okay, you understand? You understand why? Why this is good?
Stop using your air buttons, they scare me.
Okay, so now we'll incorporate the other half, which is throw, right?
Oh god. Her throw is good.
Your throw range is huge. Stand still, stand still.
Wait. No.
Stand
no,
still.
No.
God damn it.
Okay, you have this done. Here. I'll stand right here.
There we go. That's the limit of the throw range. It's like right here, right? Do you see how far this is, by the way? This is super fucking far. This is like the limit. This is right inside your 2A range, right?
Any other properties in the throw that I should know?
Nope. Other than you get a meaty afterwards.
Okay.
Man, I wish I could
teach
it.
That's not it, the meaty.
I wish I could teach stuff like this to anyone.
What is the meaty, though?
Just do 2A.
No, it's not close enough. Wait.
Do you dash?
Never mind.
Oh.
2A.
Step dash, of course.
Okay, right?
I feel stupid.
I don't know if I could teach anybody anything.
Now, try and open me up, alright? Think,
something.
Think.
And you're pretty good at teaching another thing, but I will not.
No, go. Open. Open me up.
Why not
open this pit up.
No.
You're
pushing
you
yourself too far out. No.
It's yo.
Stop pressing B buttons.
Oh, fucking duh.
You. Now we've seen like, I don't know, like fucking 10 characters. This shit's crazy, man.
Damn it.
Nope.
Can't.
Yeah, he can tell I'm gonna do that.
You also have throw, don't forget.
Right. Alright. That was a mistake.
You're plus there. Why are you blocking?
Mistake.
I don't know. I genuinely cannot tell you.
There we go.
Okay. I need to practice the dash one, but
pretty sure I just heard some like really loud fire sirens, like fire truck sirens, and like really loud music being played from some fucking car at
the
same time, which is a surreal phenomenon.
The Soldier Boy?
What?
Was it Soldier Boy?
My god,
what?
Dude.
Was it Soldier Boy?
No, Soldier Boy, no.
Stop doing that, okay. Dumbass.
Bad.
Okay. What item am I pressing? I'm plus.
I don't
No, you're not mixing it up.
All right. Tell me.
You're doing this. That's why I can stand block it, right? Because I know whenever there's a B button inserted, I can just stand block because I don't have anything to fear, right? Do you understand?
Right. I'm doing that.
You see? Like. You see? Right? There? So now, like, you have to insert the other parts, right? Uh-huh. Like, you have to do 2A6C, right?
So very... The B buttons are truly just holding you back.
Yeah, like stop.
Oh. I genuinely cannot tell what you're going to do.
Yep. Right?
That was good.
So, do you understand why this is scary, right?
Because you can either... Every time you 2A, I don't know if you're going to grab, if you're going to 6C, if you're just going to reset.
Yep.
So, I guess you're consciously thinking about this all the time.
Mm-hmm.
I don't have the mental capacity for that.
Well, you don't have to. You just choose an option. I'm not... Like, the thing is, I'm not actually trying to predict what you're going to do. I'm just choosing an option, right? And seeing how you respond.
Yeah, so you kind of have that programmed already as a sub-team. Which is to say, I just need to do this in training.
Training right now.
So, you see... Part of this also is that 6C is airborne, so it beats throw, right? So if you try and tech a throw, an I6C doesn't work.
Like that, yes.
Yeah. So you have an option that beats throw and resets pressure, and is effectively a high. You have a really fast, really strong low option, and
you have a good throw with a good range.
Yeah. Right. So, like, ignore all the B buttons, right? Ignore the B buttons, just do 2A6C. There we go. 2A6C throw. Nice. Good hit. Nice. Good throw.
Say thanks.
Yeah. I keep thinking that 2B will link because, well, where I come from, it does.
Where's that?
The thing is, if you were to predict, okay, this 2A out of whatever my bullshit is, yeah.
Well, you're not hitting the 2A correctly after that. See? I'm trying to tech there so I get hit. I get hit by the low, right?
Wait. You're getting hit by the low when you got by 60?
Well, okay. You think a throw is coming, right? So what do? You tech, right?
You teching forward?
But it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter, right? But the 2A catches someone trying to stand tech because they stand up, right? And if they're crouch teching, right? If they're crouch teching by doing this, right? That kind of thing.
Delay it, right?
You just press 6C, and then they get counter hit.
Like that. Or more like that, yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so like, try it. Okay. Nope.
Okay.
Yeah, I
standing.
Oh.
Bach is standing again.
Why is that?
Because, learning how to drop feet sucks.
Oh no.
Not the focus of the picture, but the fact that they're there means I can't bullshit it.
It's inherently problematic.
Too predictable.
Hands are easier than feet for me.
You need to redash. You need to dash in as well.
Just draw hands then.
What? Draw hands on the feet?
Yeah.
Nope.
Draw a chimp?
Yeah.
I don't know, man.
Good artistic principle, I think.
Chimps are funny, but this would be nightmarish.
Okay. There's a lot of things I'm not doing right. It's a very simple thing, and yet...
There we go. You saw the little two-way hit? That's what you want.
Bum, bum, bum.
So the secret is to vary the number and the timings, right?
Yes.
There we go. See? This is Frollo's one. If you haven't noticed, this is what he does.
Two and then goes in.
Yep.
Like, I know it's predictable somehow, but my brain didn't. I'm not conscious of what it is that's the tell.
Okay. Nope. When you push yourself too far out, you always resort to 6C. That's the thing.
Yeah.
That's how I can tell, right?
Well, now I said it.
There you go.
Bro.
I feel like we should be doing something productive.
Okay, he did it. Actually, no, it's because I had a gap in it. Like, if I did it correctly, yeah, I would have called it out.
I don't even know if I was calling on good or not.
Good.
Wait, is this...
I guess it's correct.
Oh, he blocked standing, though.
It's more productive than it is not productive.
Nice.
You know, me drawing as a hobby.
Yeah.
That's because it produces something, right?
Not sure.
Not kind of just, loafing around.
I mean, what I've been doing, like, September or something.
Damn.
I mean, I guess in other characters you can extrapolate this from, like, three buttons and a throw, or two buttons and a throw to, whatever the end of that sentence is.
Yeah, of course. This pressure is, like, obviously leagues above a lot of other characters, but... Nice.
Damn, last week of labs for the Linux sysadmin decal. So, after this, I'm all done. We're in the endgame now. A month out from graduation. Fuck,
oh,
man!
There.
We're in the
infinity. I'm gonna start doing shield, too, so try and call out shield.
Oh god.
I understand
nope.
So little about the situation that I'm in right now.
There we go. Good.
I mean, that's one thing you can do.
Gotta fucking organize things.
This is storytelling at all.
Kind
of fucks it up.
The guy that is actually funny. You really are the Superman for a quest.
Ow.
My favorite part of that.
Nice.
When they
stick
the title.
else I'm gonna dash in.
I knew Googly Gareth Germa video. Let me put in the thread. Come on. Alright, there we go. Oh, it's with the teacher noise. I know the teacher
nice.
Noise.
Okay, if I repeat the pattern too much, he'll know exactly what I'm doing.
Nice, good.
Oh, God.
Well, I didn't dash, I kind of walked.
You don't need to dash. That's the thing.
I don't need
right.
to. If I just do one, I'm close enough, I don't need. Yeah.
Well, your mic just got a lot louder.
Oh, well, I moved
that's
it.
Okay, actually, that's probably for the best. I think you were a bit
okay.
quieter before.
Did the mic pick that fast. Noise up?
What noise?
It was a burp.
Oh, no, I didn't hear anything.
It was very sudden.
That was awkward.
It was okay. just, bah. And that was it.
Wop. Wop. Why do I...
Wop people.
Okay.
What are you, fucking Friday Night Funkin', bro?
Wop people.
Beep bopple. Beep beep.
I don't even know what that game sounds like. I just know it from memes.
Kind of bop.
Try to use your two ways like a frame trap as well.
People are really into the character that's like four shapes.
Nice.
What shape?
Nice.
They're like four shapes. Those characters are like very small and simple designed out of like.
Oh, yeah.
Circles.
Sure. Yeah. Newgrounds signature. A throwback to the old days.
Oh. Yeah.
You actually thought I was going to throw.
Yeah,
nice.
It is a Newgrounds game, isn't it?
Yeah. So if I'm trying to stand tech you, you need to frame trap me, right? So counter hit my throw attempt. So don't get thrown is the thing.
The frame trap being the
But just the two way. Just the two way. What two way or 6C? Either one.
Wow.
Okay. Cool. Is that at the end of the video?
No.
It's not over yet.
Are we adding aerials?
Nope.
Are we adding combo?
Nope.
Confirms?
Nope. This is all
okay.
you're gonna learn how to do with this character.
Alright. I feel like you were standing shield that time. But...
Yeah, you can standing shield two ways.
Is Don't that get... universal?
Yep, kind of.
I like how, okay, my problem used to be that when I try to get a, try to get 3C, I would always, go over and then just get quarter circle forward. Ow.
Nice. Do you see that little hit there? That's what you want.
Did stop. That wasn't really a combo, but it was cool. I walk backwards. Like, what am I trying to accomplish with that?
Well, there is reasons to walk backwards.
There are, but not right now.
This is a different one, but this follows the same theory, right?
That being.
Yeah, my understanding of the
thing
is garbage.
So you understand like how this pressure kind of works, right? So like it's obviously not as separated because I'm using the rebeats and everything.
Uh-huh.
But like at a certain point, I have to dash back in because I push myself out, right? Every character
yes.
has these follows
Every
these
character
same
does
rules.
Those things.
So eventually, characters have to go for some kind of mix-up or just decide to back off, right?
Yep.
In our case, we aren't backing off.
In your case, you're backing off. Did I hear it correctly?
No, I know. In this situation, we aren't. We just refuse to back off.
Abe, I don't even have an understanding of anatomy.
Yeah. Okay. That's what I thought.
I don't know if I do either. I see something, and I'm like, let me just approximate that by throwing an erasing into what looks like a thing that isn't horrifying.
Well, hey. Whatever works.
Yeah. I guess my method of drawing is so fucking whack and not classically trained.
Classically trained.
Like they teach you to draw like the basic shape of something before doing details, and I fucking will do backwards from that.
So I'm guessing the blowback edge is also a high thing.
No, it's not a high, it's just a mid.
Well, I don't have to block it standing.
Nope, it has no special properties.
Oh, okay.
It is just 0-1 block, right? It's 0-1 block and big.
Big.
It also seems to push you back quite a lot, but you can fall off.
Well, thinking about it like this, right? You block this button, right? And you want to press something. It is my advantage, right? Because
right.
even if I don't cancel it, we're still zero. But I can still frame trap you if I have cancel options left, you know? And if I'm really close to you, you know, it can be really bad news for you. So you kind of understand how every character, like Riaz is obviously at one end of the pressure scale, but every character does this in some form. You understand that?
Like high, low, and throw.
Well, the high low isn't really necessary, but the idea of like plus frames, right? The only thing that Riaz 6C does is it basically like is another form of dashing back in that's a little safer. If I whiff a button like that, you have freedom. Think of it like think of this like stand blocking a Riaz 6C, right?
Wait, think of a whiff as
the whiff cancel, like that, right?
Okay.
There are no characters who are like plus after that, right? It is a pressure reset thing, right?
Same thing as like that back in basically.
Yeah.
You just have to kind of react to that.
Thank you. And then you expand your brain further and you realize that dashing back in is the same thing as air dashing back in, right?
What, how so? Like for the offense or for the defense?
Well, it's a way to reset pressure on offense, right?
Well, yes. It's like, well, now we got verticality.
And some of the buttons that beat like, you know, that beat dashing back in don't necessarily beat air dashing back in, right?
That's true, because sometimes it whip.
So then let's talk about like jumping out, right? Jumping out of pressure is really good, right? So the same thing with dashing and the same thing with air dashing in. Is that if you meet them in, if you like jump forward, right? So I'm gonna do a redash after the 5C, 5A, right?
What's that
after
like?
This. Okay. You jump forward and then you can air dash out, right? Then you're out of there, kind of, right? It's not as good of a situation, but it is a situation. Jump forward, jump forward, jump forward. Right? It's a little slow, but that's fine, right? You're in a different situation, which is where you want to be. You're not being directly pressured. You didn't let them reset pressure against you, right?
Yes.
Now press JA while rising.
What?
Press JA while rising after jumping.
While rising? That's like TK?
No, just press it as you're going up. Right?
That's like a second word.
Just while you're moving upwards, while you're rising into the air. Yeah, like that. Okay.
Wow, I'm dancing.
Okay, now do it after the 5C with 5A, right?
That wasn't right.
And boom, instant counter hit, right?
To do it. You can tell he wants to.
This is how like standardized pressure works, right?
Yes. Yes. Standardization of pressure. Oh.
And then what your character can do changes
the formula bit.
The methodology, right?
Wow, I actually used 2B correctly. Looking for the one thing.
One thing. Don't know how.
It doesn't even matter.
No matter how you try.
Are you doing this?
Nope. You just have to understand that Roa is the exact same beast.
No, he's not. Crime, I might say.
see it? Do you see it? Do you understand now? He can force his own plus frames, but at some point he has to dash back in.
Because it's too far.
And that's the space where there's the gap, right?
Yeah.
Or he does this, right?
Literally forever. Well, he does that.
See, the thing is, at some point he has to reset pressure, and the reason why he's so good is because of this, right? Because you have to react to something like orb set 22C.
But these shoes aren't even close to correct. Why are they selling these?
And like, that's what makes him so scary, right? Is because the throw factor isn't a huge part of him, because he doesn't need to generate more advantage, right, with something like a throw. But he does have to dash back in, eventually, right? And part of what makes him really good is that his orbs are a free dash back in, right? Because of how plus they are.
That anime.
The boots might be like vaguely closer to correct here. The very first cover arc, but every other cover has these other shoes.
So that's why Roa's pressure is, like, exceptional, right? It's because of his ability to dash back in, like, and generate plus frames for himself at kind of an unprecedented rate while also generating resources, you know? But he is not immune to, like, the rules of it, right? The orb set, the vertical lightning coming down, the orb set 22C, there's a gap in there. So if you predict it, you can mash it out, right?
Wait, there is?
Yep.
What?
Whoever convinced themselves that this is the correct...
Wait.
Why are there like 16 different versions?
I'm going to do 5B, or 2A, 5B, orb set 22C. Okay?
Fucking China.
That.
It's after his 2C.
Nope, it's during. It's while the orb is being set. Oh. See? Like that.
Why does the seal sound like a man?
You have to do it very quickly, and it is a guess, right? There's no way in hell you react to orb set 2C. Unless it's that. That you can react to, but it's very hard. The charged orb you can react to, because it's but it's very difficult. And
oh, so this is not charged. I mean, the orb charge is like, it's the same for every bucket, right?
Yep. You can't press after the 2C.
Right.
I think you can't press in between if it's... No, you can press in between if there's the stops of lightning too. Anyways. But every character follows like the same fundamental rules of how they operate their pressure, right? And they're all looking for kind of the same things, right? Is like, they want to be uncontested on their pressure resets, so that's why they frame trap, right? To dissuade you from doing a lot of things to try and move out of the pressure, right?
Well, can I JA out of?
You can, but your JA is pretty bad.
It just kind of goes really high, so I got...
Well, here's the thing, right? do jumping JA and then try an air dash. Right? You can't?
Interesting.
Or JA double jump?
Hold on. I just like doing this.
Nope, oh. Right? You can't, right?
You can't really.
But other characters can do this, right?
I mean, it's this moon in particular. So you can do it.
Yeah, it's because the JA is not like a fast auto cancelable thing. You also don't get two of them like other characters.
Wait, that's normal?
Yep. Anyways, so then, like, that applies to every character, right? And then, if we want to do, like, F-Moon characters, right?
Oh, boy.
Like, especially Ryogi.
Like this one? You mean like this? Okay. Yeah.
Like, here's how we apply it, essentially, right? One of the things is that this character's a fuck ton of unblockables, right?
Oh, yes. That's the whole game, baby.
So, like, you notice that all your normals, you can't, like, run back in, really, afterwards, right? And you can't really throw after them, right?
No, that's... A lot of characters can, but...
Well, you can't. Right? So, now we have, like, things to force the other person to move, right? So we have, like... We have things to make people wait, like, not want to sit and, like, take your stuff, you know? What I mean?
Take your shit.
So, like, that's where the Rekka and the Unblockable comes in, right? We can kind of harass people from a distance where they can't respond, right? So our pressure reset isn't a dash back in, it's like maybe a walk forward or... going into your Rekka series, right?
Yeah.
Because these are, it's just a bunch of mix-ups.
I'm not going to react to my own Rekka. No way in hell. I'm not going to react to that.
And like, we don't ever do it empty, but we also don't have to ever put ourselves in a position of danger, right? Because the Rekka can end safely.
That's not safe. Whatever.
Yeah, but you can just, you know, that,
you can
right?
Do that.
And that's safe.
That
so we condition them, right? So we condition them to respect our pressure, right? Because like at this space, it's not exactly scary. Like Ryogi's not a scary character from this distance, right? Because she can just mix you up with normal stuff, right? But they do something stupid, like try and jump out, and then you hit them, right? And then you wait until someone is fast enough to react with shield to the unblockables, right? And then you just do nothing. And then we get the fattest combo, right?
You dropped it.
Well, just shut up. Pay attention.
right?
It's pretty reactable, right?
A lot of people.
But the idea is we overwhelm the mental stack, right?
I'm not very good at that. I realize I'm not really good at practicing that with this character. That's what I'm doing wrong.
And we do have one boon.
Yeah, like
we have a singular button to reset pressure with.
Let me guess. Is it? No. You're not. Oh. That's what you're doing. That's what.
Yep.
You're
doing. It is plus +5. But it is also, you know. Almost
one
use, one time use.
Hopefully that's all you need.
Nice.
Well, you delayed it. Otherwise I couldn't have healed.
Keep in mind that you only get like 2 chances, right?
Hearing a dog bark? Yeah. Okay, I kind of see what you mean.
So we utilize the unblockables, right? Because they are like not full combo, but damage, you know?
They are. It's conditional.
Yeah. That's an exchange for your throw, basically, right?
Well, I do use throw sometimes. What the? Okay. Anyways.
Some more understanding.
Insight gained.
Okay, and also a little bit about the movement. Just a little bit. Right?
Alright.
Just play legitimate, right? Just do it.
Just do it. Whips, oh, come on.
Okay. How did you lose?
Bad neutral.
Yeah. Well,
no.
When did you lose neutral?
Really, really, it is bad defense.
How so?
Yeah.
How so?
Let's see. Let's use an example. Like, I mean, okay, like you said, this character doesn't really dash in much, but there's like this like funny stuff like the unblockables, the I got out once scot-free with the knife.
Well, what did you get hit with? What was the button you got hit most with?
I think it was 2B.
And why?
Because I'm kind of mashing outside of my...
Well, were you getting counter hit by it?
Well, now you mention it. I guess it was because... I think I intended to mash, but...
Well, we can run it again, and then you can try and be conscious of it.
Well, that was it. Okay, not sure. Gonna have to see again. That's my fault for trying to KA. Okay, well, I'm not moving.
Exactly. Do you see it?
I didn't really move at all. So you could know exactly where my button reached.
Yeah.
Whereas I have to kind of...
You're trying to preempt my movement where I have complete control of our spacing.
Yeah, that's a... Yeah, I cannot put that. Right. You're the one who's controlling the spacing.
Yeah. So that's why you're getting clipped by 2B so much, is because you're trying to walk backwards, right? Because you've realized that you've lost control of the spacing, and now you're trying to make distance so you can reset the space so that it's even between the two players, right? But I'll dash back in and hit you with 2B, right?
Fuck this hat.
Or you whiff a button and I dash in and punish you with 2B, right?
Yeah, what hat?
Stupid fucking hat.
So, try and be proactive, right? There, run it again.
I will open my mind's eye.
Do things like jump at me.
This hat, I can't figure out what the fuck it is or how it's shaped. I can't find a real life example anywhere.
Nope, you're like being too passive.
Nah, it's a felt hat. It's like a fedora almost. This one looks like a fucking bowler. Because there's no visible crease.
Yeah, there's no shading at all.
It's all supposed to be the same hat. That one has fucking wreath in it. I think I'll just get a normal wide brim fedora. Big, what's that?
Compare the bump on top to the brim on the top photo. Bowler hats usually don't have brims like that.
Yeah, that's true.
It's like a cowboy hat with a bow. Because there's the indent in the middle on top.
I'd say more like a wide brim fedora. But the fedora has this one actually looks pretty good. But usually the crease is there's too many front creases and stuff. It makes it too folded.
Yeah.
Lock and code easier. But this one probably costs $400 or some shit.
Don't do that.
And I'd have to replace the ribbon with a big white satin ribbon, and I don't really know how to do that. I don't know if I'd have to cut it or sew it or something.
Is this hat talk going in the video?
Yep, everything's getting recorded. But think about this critically for a second. When you air dash, you are giving up control of spacing. Tell me why that is.
Oh my god, it actually is $420.
Because you're just running away from no reason. You're giving the opponent that space to catch up.
Well, more importantly, why do you lose control of the spacing when you air dash?
It's a fucking hat.
Because they're just, you're kind of locked in that animation, right?
Exactly, right? So this is why when, you're trying to control space, you control space on the ground, right?
At Supreme logo.
So So that's why like I'll back off and try and do that is because I'm trying to control space on the ground because I have a life lead and therefore I can afford to have you have to make riskier plays in order to equalize our advantage, right? That's why I can back off there. But we can't back off when there's equal life totals because then your opponent has no reason to go in, right? They can play the spacing game with you. And if they play the spacing game better than you, then you'll lose.
Just play when you're down, if they're down, just play better.
Kind of. But like there's a reason why you want to always be advancing forward because you control more space that way, right? But you don't want to be advancing forward in a way that you lose control, right? That's why typically
literally that last hit, you 5B me when I was air dodging.
Yeah. When someone is in the air, they lose a lot of control over their spacing, right? There's this video called like Foundational Melty Movement by JG. And the thing about like someone in the air is that they only have control up to the options they have, right? So they can so once they jump, right, they have an air dash, then they have a double jump, right? That's the limit, that's the extent of their space control, which is why the person on the ground is advantaged. Here, let's go again. And like the FTSE's handbook says, you don't have to be the best neutral player to win. You can just be aggressive enough or defensive enough to never have to fight them. You were you're walking backwards.
Why you jump?
We're zoomed in. One leg is so much bigger than the other. And I can't tell which one looked right.
Well, that's just me dropping my input, which is another thing.
The artist's eternal struggle. Struggled to not become external.
Yeah.
True.
That was better, but keep in mind.
Wait, where the fuck did I melt?
Did you lose track of your melty blood?
Why is blood melting?
Truly, an unanswerable question.
You saw how you ran up to me? I lost control of that situation and was forced to block.
And I did nothing.
Yeah, exactly.
Say something. Why? Fuck. Fuck ass fuck. Thank you.
You got hit jumping.
Why did I jump though?
I don't know.
Oh.
Steve. Mauled.
Could have full combo there.
Yeah. I wanted to see if you were ready to react.
Nope. I tuned out when I'm like, oh, he's just going to finish that combo.
Yeah, that's a bad habit. Nice.
Habit? Whap. Me?
What?
Dog.
Nice.
I thought I heard
well,
a helicopter.
Good.
I think I understood that situation, but okay.
I was just gonna dog it.
What?
You didn't hear a helicopter, it was just Gaga.
Gaga.
That round was better, but you see how like you have to play like a little aggressive in order to own the space you are in.